Hello and welcome to the 2D Presence Inspection Tools video of the Signova series. In this tutorial, I will show you how you can identify the presence or absence of details of your parts in a few simple steps. For a general introduction to Signova and the Object Locator tool, I recommend to watch the Discover Signova in a few minutes product tour video. Now, let's inspect some parts. As always, I use the chocolate bar, but this time inspect the presence of the chocolate bar within the wrapper and that the best before date is printed. To follow along, get yourself an Inspector A30 with the Signova sensor app and download and print the chocolate sample wrappers. Your local SIG sales representative is happy to help you. My Inspector A30 is mounted parallel to the surface with a distance of around 35 cm. It's connected to my PC using the USB-C interface, as it's super easy, but Ethernet works fine as well. To access the user interface, open a web browser like Google Chrome and enter the default IP address 169.254.0.1. I place the chocolate straight and centered in the field of view, as it makes applying the analysis tools way easier. If your image doesn't look as well lit and sharp as mine, I recommend to watch the Image Acquisition Inspector A30 tutorial. Switch to Configure in the top right corner and click Update Reference Image below the live image. You will automatically switch to the Reference tab. There, I will first apply the Object Locator tool on the brand logo to locate the chocolate bar in the field of view. I switch to Live and move the chocolate bar around. As long as the area around the brand logo is green, the localization works fine. If it turns red, you might be outside of the field of view or you exceeded the rotation threshold of 10 degrees. Here, the localization works fine. Now, let's inspect if the chocolate bar is within the wrapper using the pixel counter tool. The pixel counter counts pixels within a specified intensity range within its region of interest. In our case, the background is very bright, represented by high intensity values, so we search and count only darker pixels. Switch back to reference, select the already applied object locator tool, click on Add Tools at Analysis, and select pixel counter. Move the pixel counter region to the visible part of the chocolate bar and adjust the size to be within the chocolate edges. Adjust the upper limit of the intensity settings. In my case, I use approximately 200. This helps to ignore the bright background, but includes the brightness of the different chocolate variants. Increase the lower threshold of the coverage result, in my case to approximately 80%. So if more than 80% of the pixels in the pixel counter region are dark enough, the tool result will be a pass. Change to live and inspect the results while placing and moving different chocolate bars around. In case only a small part of the chocolate bar sticks out of the wrapper or the chocolate is not visible at all, the pixel counter will report a fail. And finally, let's inspect if a best before date has been printed using the Blob Finder tool. This tool finds and counts blobs within its region of interest. A blob is defined as a cluster of connected pixels with a specified intensity and area range. In our application, we want to inspect the presence of 7 characters but not read the actual printed text. To apply it, switch to Reference, select the Object Locator, click on Add Tool in the Analysis section and select Blob Finder. Move and resize the Blob Finder section to just include the best before date. As the text is printed in white on a dark background, adjust the right-hand intensity threshold to maximum 255 and the left-hand intensity threshold to around 100. So we ignore all dark pixels of the background. Find the number of blobs in the result section. It states 7 found blobs, which is correct. To use this value as a pass-fail criteria, simply change both the lower and upper limit to 7. So only if 7 blobs are found, the result will be pass. Any other number will result in a fail. Change to live and inspect the results while exchanging and moving different chocolate bars. As you see, this configuration works independent of the chocolate type. So no need to reconfigure the camera for each switchover. Wow, that was easy, wasn't it? Presence inspection tools can be used in a wide range of industries and applications. For example, counting pills in blister packs, checking components on electronic boards, or locating objects of undefinable shape like fruits or vegetables. In the upcoming tutorials, I will show you how to do even more advanced inspections using the quality inspection and AI tools. If you can't wait to get started, reach out to your local SIG sales representative to find out more about the incredible world of SIG Nova.